How you doing?
I'm ready, sir.
Thank you.
herself to sickness, O God. But she shall live to declare the works of you, O God. Strengthen her heart even now, O God. Let your peace envelop her, God. this is the day that the Lord has made, and I shall rejoice and be glad in it. This is my cousin right here, Tarrance Timone Belle. I saw many of y'all just call him T-Buck. Amen.
Amen.
And I don't know about you, but when I saw a vision of him, look like running around in heaven to me. It settled my spirit. Boy, so I promised in my heart that I did not come to mourn like I had no hope. I'm looking forward to seeing T-Book, T.T. again. You can think what you want to think. I'm talking about how God ministered to me.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. So at this time, beloved of God, we are going to uplift this family in prayer. Friends, amen. We're going to continue to pray. And so I believe we've already had our musical prelude. Yes, and we've had several of them, amen. And so at this time, I want you to be aware that we're going to follow the order of service as the family has diligently had printed. So don't get in here trying to be new and trying to do too much, amen?
Amen.
Y'all don't like me, but I love you, amen. I'm just teasing, guys. At this time, we're going to go right now with my father in the ministry, Reverend Clayton Hodge. He's going to come with a prayer, and after that, you will hear from my honey, the Reverend Patrick Snell right here, and my first cousin, Brother Terry Barris, who I'd like to say Minister Barris, because he's always preaching. And so after that, we'll hear from that beauty queen called Naomi. She's going to come. I believe that's Naomi Griffin. And so she's going to come up. And so then we'll just follow as printed. Amen?
Amen.
Pastor Hodge.
Hey, Pastor Hodge.
Hey, Melissa. Let us pray. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for your steadfast love, for your mercy toward us that is renewed for us each and every morning. No matter the sins that we have committed by thought, word, or deed, thank you for choosing to love us more than we can ever love ourselves. Lord, we don't deserve it, but you show your kindness toward us relentlessly. Lord, forgive me, forgive us for yesterday's problems and shortcomings. Lord, we grieve over anything we have done that make a mockery of your merciful love. Lord, we give ourselves completely to you. We love you, Lord. Help us to love you more. Weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning. Lord, bring joy. Bring comfort. Bring peace. Bring understanding to this family and this waiting congregation. Lord, we need you more than ever before, because you are a God of comfort. And as you comfort us, we can comfort one another. We ask in Jesus' name, amen.
There's been a change in the Old and New Testament. Now this time we're going to have Terry Barris come and do the Old Testament.
Can everybody stand up for about 15 seconds to give this wonderful, powerful man, T.T., a standing ovation for his life, his love, and his loyalty. I'll be reading out of Ecclesiastes chapter 7, verse 1 through A good name is better than fine perfume. And how many people know that TT was a good name? Can somebody say TT?
TT.
TT. TT was a good name. And the day of death is better than the day of birth. It is better to go to the house of the mourning than to go to the house of the feasting. For death is the destiny of everyone. The living should take this to heart. Sorrow is better than laughter because a sad face is good for the heart. The heart of the wise is in the house of the mourning, but the heart of fools is in the house of pleasure. Praise God.
I'll read the New Testament. You can find this in St. John 14, chapter 2, verse 6. It's in my Father's house of many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again, and I will receive you unto myself, that where I am, there you may be also. And where I go, ye may know. And the way, you know, Thomas said to him, Lord, we do not know where you are going. How can we tell the way? Jesus replied and said unto them, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man comes unto the Father except by me. Church, get your ticket while you can today. God bless you.
At this time, Sister Naomi, y'all get ready to be blessed.
Amen. Amen. Praise God.
Amen.
Amen. Praise God.
Praise God.
Oh, Jesus.
Amen.
Miss Valerie, I love you. Family, I love you. My deepest sympathy and condolences to everyone. Jesus, help me. Alone in a room, it's just me. Yeah.
mind, then, you know, we want you to jump up like popcorn, but we want you to sit down like popcorn, too, don't we? They say in 2 minutes, actually, that's a lot of time to say it, amen.
Amen. Amen.
So at this time, we're having reflections, and they did not designate, so you don't have to wait on anybody. You could go like 1, 2, 3, now. Reflections. Thank you, my queen.
Amen.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
I know I'm not out of place. This is Tarrance, baby girl. She wrote a poem the day that we left the funeral home. And she's gonna read it. If she can't, her Nana will.
Amen. Amen.
I love you, Daddy. I will be looking up at you. Will be looked down at me. Daddy, I, Gary,
I'm gonna
miss you putting me on the bus. I'm gonna miss you coming to check on me. You are my super dad.
She's gonna miss him putting her on the bus. He used to meet my mom every morning to put her on the bus. So she's gonna miss that. That's all she talked about, putting her on the bus. And I didn't know who was the parent because she ran the show. She would call and say, bring me a pizza. He gonna go get that pepperoni pizza. Yeah, he gotta come bring the money to my mom and she's gonna be And we have another one, that a letter that he wrote, T-H-O, and she's gonna read it. Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
This is a letter that Tarrance wrote to Asia. Hey, baby girl, happy birthday, big head, and how's my baby doing? I miss you so much, and you mean everything to me, and I love you with all my heart. I got your school pictures, your mama sent me, and you look like a beautiful princess, baby girl. I can't wait to come home to be with you and your mommy, and yes, we are going to move in our own house in the pool. You really put a smile on my face from the things you say, and you are such a smart little girl. Or should I say little woman, because that's what you act like. Well, big head, I hope this be the last birthday I miss. But if I do miss another one, that really would be the last one, I promise you. Better stay looking pretty for me and be good in school, okay? You are my heart, and I miss you and love you always. And can't nobody take that away. Make a birthday wish for me and stay sweet. Love that attitude.
How everybody doing today, man? Hey, listen, I'm a represent for us, man. We 77. I see a lot of my people in here with me. I see Zorrell. Man, so many of us, Quentin, Terry, we all know T-Buck, man, TT, growing up at the park. I'm gonna keep it real, he was the most cussiest little thing out of all of us. He cussed the most. Y'all know TT, y'all know when we came up. He was the one doing all the cussing, man. I hate that we here on this occasion, but I'm grateful that we are here on this occasion, man. Y'all know it's Buck transitioned over the years, man. He became a hell of a man, you know what I'm saying, and a great friend and one of my brothers. We weren't as close as most of some of the other guys, but we always checked in, man. And it's crazy. I was up at Cat Williams two Fridays ago, and I seen Quan walking through. And then to find out the news on that Saturday, man, it changed my energy. And I know the city, man. I know the city felt this one. You know what I'm saying?
Yes, but
he a goat, man. He jumped out there on that porch about 14, 15. He a legend. You know what I'm saying? We know he a legend, man.
Yeah.
Knows me as Hunger Brooks. Mm-hmm. My name came from Naples when I was 16. My Tarrance, as Val knows, that's all I ever called him when he was a little boy. Mm-hmm. And he'd come up and smile at me. And I would say, I'm your cousin, but he said, Fran, I said, nope, I'm your cousin, but what do you want to call me, Miss Fran or Auntie Fran? And Auntie shows respect. He said, I'll call you Auntie Fran. And it was Auntie Fran from then on. But I just want to tell you just one story. It was very adventurous, very smart. When he was about 2 years old, and I had come down from New York, and I was living with my sister Deborah. One morning, we heard this banging on the door, so we didn't know what was going on, so we peered out, didn't see anybody. Looked down, here was a little two-year-old, banging on the door, at the bottom of this bottle, looking for Jared. We opened the door, we smiled, we always tell that story to this day, that how did you find this apartment at 2 years old, all the way around the other complex. And he found my sister's apartment. How he found it at 2, I'll never know. But he was so smart and so adventurous. And I was at the reunion. I was glad he hugged me and kissed me. But this pain will lessen one day. Just hasn't done it yet. Mm-hmm.
Good morning, church.
Good morning.
Good morning, church.
Good morning.
Good morning, church.
Good morning.
I say good morning, church.
Good morning.
I'm gonna represent for TT.
Amen.
That's my brother.
Amen.
That's my brother.
Amen.
Trust me, that's my brother. He wouldn't have it no other way.
Amen.
I'm gonna tell you about TT. I had to come to Naples with my daddy. Everybody know Joe Lewis, the neighborhood.
Won't he do it?
So I was adopted into the Parker, the Bell, the Perry, all the families around there. I had to make friends. And I made friends with the Bell family that we clicked. And Joe Lewis would cut TT hair a little shag. He run out the door. Fanny got to go to work. Jamie got to go play ball. He runs out the door. Ah! Right. From my Alma come to the door. Ah! All that hot! All that hot! Get back in here, boy! Now I want heaven. And he want heaven in it. I want to go with Jamie. I want to go with my father. He wanted to go. So that being said, he always wanted to go with Vanna and JB. And JB say, that's his boy.
That's his boy.
Amen.
And you could take that. That's his boy.
That's
so
right.
He gone with his dad. That's his boy. So later on in life, me and TT journey was unique. We had a very unique journey. It wasn't no time that TT called me, I wasn't there. There wasn't no time that that family called me, I wasn't there. Because it wasn't no time that I called that family, they wasn't there for me. When I was at my lowest point in my life, that family was there for me. I'm going to tell you, I was in incarcerated hospital. Ooh, glory to God. I was incarcerated. I was tired of going to my daddy's house. And I stayed with his grandma. Me and Tommy Bell.
Running in and out.
Mr. Emma said, God, boy, y'all stop that running. So I turned myself in and went to Collier County Jail. And it wasn't a time that I didn't get a card from Patty Bell. Mm-hmm. She was right there for me. So when I got out, during that time when I was with Tukey, we had the opportunity to move some shoes. And they was Reeboks. So that's the reason why I got on some white Reeboks. He gone to the mall at Finish Line to get another pair of Reeboks. But guess who got them spotted Reeboks? I did. Brother, I got 10 pair a week. My time is running out. So my time is running out. So with that being said, I have something else to read before I get off the stage. It says, I am with you. Good morning, everybody. Praise God, everybody.
Praise God.
Love your neighbor.
I love my neighbor.
Guess what? I want everybody to put their chin up, because this is a celebration.
Amen.
This is a celebration. Trust me, it's a celebration.
Amen.
So we're gonna let Auntie come on up.
Amen.
Amen.
Honor to the pulpit. My Bethel family, the people that were always there for me, Reverend Hodge, Brother Snell, and my I'm the big sister, but that's my sister. That's my sister. I couldn't sit there any longer without getting up and giving honor to the Bell family, my sister Valley, my niece Tukey. Like Evelyn said, my brother came into T.T.'s and Tukey's life. T.T. was 3 months old when him and Valley got together. That's my nephew.
Amen.
He's always been raised, and you could tell him nothing. Yes, he had an earthly father, but blood don't always make you a family. The person that loves you, nurtures you, and will go to the end with you, the good and the bad, makes you family.
Amen.
My brother, J.B. Blackman, even though he's already gone,
Amen.
His dying wish on his deathbed, we had a three-way call with T.T. because T.T. wasn't here when he passed. And it always just rings in my head. T.T. said to him, Daddy, please hold on. I'm coming, Daddy, because you've always been there for me. I don't care who they say my daddy is. Mm. My daddy is J.B. Blackman.
Amen.
And my brother just cried, and he cried, and he tried to hold on a couple of months, and he just kept saying, I just want to see my son. And he said, "Sis, little sister, whatever happens, when you see T.T., promise him, tell him my dying wish was to take care of Valley, take care of Tukey. He loved you guys. My brother loved you guys with everything in him. We love you guys. You'll always be family. And no matter what, I don't care what nobody said.
Amen.
T.T., Tarrance, T-Buck is my nephew.
Amen.
I love you.
Amen.
We watch the news, and after the news, they got this game show called Wheel of Fortune, and there's a word puzzle that come up there, and they got three contestants, And the first contestant says, is there's a T up there? And the host said, there's two T's up there. And I think the word was little. So there was two T's up there on that board. Valerie, Tuki, there's two T's up there. Don't you worry. There's TT up there. Don't worry, don't worry, don't worry, don't worry. He is resting with God.
Amen. 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 Won't God talk to you in multiple ways? Amen. At this time, we're going to go now to the praise dance, and then we will have a tribute, and after which we will have a solo by my girl, and I can't wait. Amen. Praise dance. Praise dance. Amen.
Mm-hmm.
Beautiful. Our tribute and our song.
Precious child in my soul. Like every night that goes
want to call forth the board's staff, who always does a phenomenal job, for resolutions and acknowledgments. Praise God for the pastor.
Let the church say amen.
Amen.
Let us say amen again.
Amen.
Resolution, January 23rd, 2023. Trust in the Lord with all thy heart. Lean not to thy own understanding. In all thy ways, acknowledge him, and he shall direct your path. Proverbs chapter 3, verses 5 and 6. Today, as we mourn, as we celebrate the life of Tarrance Belle, the son of our member, Valerie Belle, we, the members of the Mount Bethel Baptist Church, want the family to know that you are in our thoughts and prayers. We encourage you to cast your cares upon the Good Shepherd, who will lead you and guide you as you walk through the valleys of sorrow. Although we don't always understand the pain God has for our lives, we know that all things work together for the good of those who love the Lord. We give him honor and we give him praise. Therefore, be it resolved today that God's divine guidance be upon this family. Amen. And that Brother Belle's memory remain in your heart and in your mind to inspire you daily in your efforts to live a life for Christ. John 16 and 33 states, I have told you these things so that in me you may have peace. But in this world you will have trouble. But take heart. I have overcome the world. Be it resolved, we the Mount Bethel Baptist Church family humbly commend the family to the Heavenly Father, who will help you and who will help you to bear your loss. Be it further resolved that a copy of this resolution be given to the family and a copy placed on our church records, properly submitted Bishop Lorenzo Robinson, pastor, 3718 Oak Street, Coleman, Florida, 33521. At this time, we have acknowledgments.
Life is eternal, the good Lord said, so do not think of T.T. as dead, but death was only his stepping stone to a beautiful life we have never known.
Amen.
A place where God promised man he would be eternally happy, safe, and free.
Amen.
A wonderful life where we never knew, but our journey on earth is over and through. So trust in God and doubt him never. For those who love him will live forever.
Amen.
And while we cannot understand, just let the Savior take your hand. For when death's angels come to go, God is so great and we are so small. And there is nothing, nothing in death that you need to fear. For faith in God makes all things clear.
Yes.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
We, the management and staff of the James C. Board for the home, let the God, thank you, praise for his life and for these beautiful 45 years that were spent together with his family. Each petal of every flower is representing a pound of love from their hearts. May God bless you and keep you is our prayer.
Amen.
At this time, we'll have a solo by another powerhouse that the Lord uses, Sister Kashana. Then afterwards, we will hear Words of Comfort by Reverend Clayton Hodge.
Amen.
Yeah.
giving honor to the Spirit of Christ, to the pulpit, to the Bell family. To be absent from the body is to be with in the presence of the Lord. And Tuki know, we just call TT the wild one, because he can just do stuff to us just because.
Every knee shall bow. Every tongue. right now. So Lord, while you're here, comfort this family. That's all you can. All you will. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. From Isaiah, the 40th chapter, a very familiar passage of scripture, starting at verse 28. Hast thou not known? Hast thou not heard that the everlasting God, the Lord, the creator of the ends of the earth, fainteth not? Neither is weary. There is no searching of his understanding. He gives power to the faint. And to them that have no might, he increases strength. But they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run, Lord have mercy, and not be weary. And they shall walk and not faint. For a thought this afternoon, I'm asking a question. How to keep moving when times get tough? How to get moving or keep on moving when times are tough? How much does God expect me to bear? Why doesn't he help me? Have you ever felt like this? Yes, yes, yes. Job pressure. Family problems. Church troubles. Health issues. Relational conflict. Financial struggles. The list is overwhelming. Difficulties. They are endless. It's hard to see a light at the end of the tunnel.
Amen.
Let alone comprehend how you could possibly walk toward it victoriously. Where can you find strength to keep going when you're so tired and weary?
Well,
thankfully, God gives us an answer, an amazing promise. Those who wait for the Lord will gain new strength. They will mount up with wings like eagles. They will run and not get tired. They will walk and not become weary. This verse isn't just about physical weakness. Emotional exhaustion can be even more draining. When we are worn out, a good night's sleep will usually renew our strength. But emotional weariness can utterly deplete us. Then fear and doubt rush in. How would I ever deal with tomorrow? God, where are you? That's exactly how the Israelites, exactly how the Belle family, and many of you felt when the Lord spoke through the prophet Isaiah. Why do you say, O Jacob, and assert, O Israel, my way is hidden from the Lord, and the justice due me escapes the notice of my God. Sometimes our circumstances make us feel that the Lord has forgotten all about us.
Amen.
If we are his children, shouldn't God rescue us from trouble and make our life pleasant and easy? Not necessarily. This attitude indicates we are forgetting that suffering and hardship are part of life, even for believers.
Yeah.
Let me pause this a moment here. Jesus Christ suffered, bled, and died. And here you are. All of us. All we want is peace, love, understanding. But it's not always that way.
Amen.
When Adam and Eve chose to follow Satan rather than God, the consequence of sin engulfed the entire world. And no one is exempt. Not even preachers, pastors, deacons, laity. Although the Lord is still sovereign over his creation, he now works out his perfect plan in the context of a fallen world. The key to victory is in hardship is found in responding rightly to them, not trying to escape. Anyone can keep going when burdens are removed. But those who trust the Lord in the midst of problems, they will persevere. However, this kind of radical trust is possible only when we know God's character and understand his purpose. Okay, I'm going to share 3 points. I'm going to take this. Point number one, you must know who God is.
Amen.
Isaiah described the Lord as the everlasting God and creator, who never becomes weary, whose understanding is inscrutable. So let's consider how these divine attributes can increase your trust in him as you walk through your troubles. While you see only your immediate need, God has an eternal perspective on your situation. Because he is the creator, he has made plans for your life. And they are being carefully worked out through each circumstance. Furthermore, he never loses track of you because you are always on his mind. And finally, he is omniscient, which means his reason for allowing trials in your life may be beyond your comprehension.
Amen.
But they are always right on time, and they are meant for your benefit.
All right.
In the same chapter, Isaiah described the Lord as a shepherd who tends, gathers, and gently leads his sheep. Here we see the greatness of God's love and mercy. He cares.
Amen.
He cares.
Yeah.
He cares.
Yes,
and provide for our needs. Carry us when we are too weak to walk, and gently guide us when we don't know where to go. All these qualities should motivate us to trust in the Lord.
Amen.
Number two, understanding what God is willing to do.
All right.
If you've ever been tempted to give up or complain to the Lord, perhaps you don't understand how much He wants to help you out. He gives strength to the weary. And to him who lacks might, He increases power. God never intends that we live out our life on our own strength. That's why He will sometimes bring us into times of weakness to show us we need to exchange our weak earthly strength for His heavenly power.
Amen.
I don't know about you, but Lord, give me Your power.
Amen.
Not just today, every day of my life. Whether you are in need of physical, emotional might, God can replenish you with divine energy.
Amen.
Point number three. Wait for the Lord. Since God has all the power, we could possibly need and desire to share it with us. We must understand how to harness it. Isaiah tells us that the key is to wait for the Lord. That is probably the last thing you want to hear when you are burdened and overwhelmed. We want relief, not delay.
That's all right.
However, waiting for the Lord is not the same as waiting for the end of a difficult situation.
Amen.
The Hebrew word translate wait comes with the idea of hope and expectation. Since we don't automatically know what to expect from God or how He's going to work in our life, we need to spend time with Him. Share with God how we feel. Turn our focus toward the Scriptures to understand what He desires to accomplish in our lives. Then we should quietly listen in anticipation for His answers. As we rely on His promises, our anxiety will be replaced with peace.
Wait
on the Lord. Be of good courage. He shall strengthen your heart.
Wait.
I say on the Lord. Sometimes I am weary. With my crying. My pillow is soaked with tears. My throat is dry. My eyes fail. While I wait for my God.
It is good
that one should hope and wait quietly for the sake.
salvation of the Lord.
Yeah.
But if we hope for what we do not see, then we eagerly wait for it with perseverance. For our heart, our citizenship in heaven, from which we also eagerly wait for the Lord. Once an evangelist took a trip to Rome, Italy, and admired the beautiful religious site. He then visited a beautiful rotunda building with a statue of Jesus in the middle, surrounded by statues of heroes, patriarchs, and apostles. All of them were pointing to Jesus. Abraham was pointing to Jesus and said, "There's nothing too hard for the Lord."
Amen.
Joseph was pointing and said, "They meant it for evil, but God meant it for good." Moses was pointing and said, "Stand still and see the glory of the Lord." Joshua was pointing and said, "As for me in my house, we will serve the Lord." David was pointing and said, "The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want." Solomon was pointing and said, Trust in the Lord with all thy heart, and lean not to your own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge him, who will direct your path." Isaiah was pointing and said, "He was wounded for our transgression. He was bruised for our iniquity." John the Baptist said, pointing and said, "Behold, the Lamb of God that takes away the sin of the world." Peter was pointing and said, "Thou art the Christ, the Son of the living God." Paul was pointing and said, "If you believe in Jesus Christ, you shall be saved." John was pointing and said, "He's Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end." Well, family, be not dismayed.
Born of a woman, having a short time to live and
full of misery. He coming up is cut down like a flower. He fled as were a shadow and never can retain in one stay. In the midst of life, we are in death. For whom may we seek for succor but of thee, O Lord God? Most holy, O Lord most mighty, O holy and merciful Savior, deliver us not into the bitter pain of death. Thou knowest, Lord, the secrets of our hearts. Put not thy merciful ears to our prayers, but spare us, Lord most holy, O God most mighty, O holy and merciful Savior, thou most merciful worthy judge, eternal, suffer us not at our last hour of any pain of death to fall from thee.
For as much as it has pleased Almighty God in his wise providence to take out of this world the soul of our deceased brother, Tarrance Bell, we therefore commit his body to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust, looking for the general resurrection in the last day and the life of the world to come through our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose second coming in glorious majesty to judge the world. The earth and the sea shall give up their dead, and the corruptible bodies of those who sleep in him shall be changed and made like unto his own glorious body, according to the mighty workings whereby he is able to subdue all things unto himself.
And this is our prayer. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us all our trespasses as we forgive others who trespass against us. And lead us not into no temptation, but deliver us from evil. Thy kingdom, power, and the glory forever. O merciful God, the Father, our Lord Jesus Christ, who is the resurrection and life, in whomsoever believeth shall live, though he died, and whosoever liveth and believeth in him shall not die. Eternity, we beseech thee, O Father, to raise us from the dead of sin unto the light of righteousness, that when we shall depart this life, we may rest in him, and at the general resurrection, at the last day, many shall be found acceptable in thy sight, and receive the blessings which thy well-beloved Son shall then pronounce to all that love and fear thee, say, come, ye blessed of my Father, receive the kingdom prepared from you from the beginning of the world. Grant this, we beseech you, O merciful Father, through Jesus Christ, our mediator and our redeemer. Amen.
Amen.
Benediction. The grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the love of God, the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all,
yes.
Now and forever. Church said, amen.
At this time, we're going to ask for some of the friends of the family to come forward and be flower attendants. Also, the pallbearers, DeAndre Bell, Daquan Henson, James Hoverwood, Dick McRae, Demetrius Henson, Terrence Bell Jr., Maurice Perry, and Todd Thomas. Come forward, come over here and stand on my left, the pallbearers. The flower attendants, can you come forward?
Thank you.
looking for some food.
I'm good.
I've been looking for food.
There were so many times when I